Ebola virus leading to death. Ebola virus was formerly known to result in Ebola hemorrhagic fever, which is a severe and rare condition that can cause a fatal illness in humans. Ebola virus is the type of infection which transmits from wild animals to human beings, and it also spreads from human to human. The death rate of the Ebola virus is around 50%, which is way too much, and the death cases report around 25 to 90% in the past few years. Ebola virus can be considered as the leading cause of death, but if a community engagement is done correctly, then the outbreak of the infection can be easily controlled. Ebola virus results in severe and acute illness, which is usually fatal and leads to death. Ebola virus was first seen in 1976 within two outbreaks. One was seen in the Nazar within South Sudan, and another one was in the Yambuku within DRC. Later, in 2014 to 2016, a more significant outbreak was seen in West Africa, where it began within Guinea and then crossed towards Liberia and Sierra Leone. In 2018 to 2019, the outbreak of the Ebola virus was seen within eastern DRC. The transmission of the Ebola virus is seen to be present within fruit bats, which serves as the natural virus hosts. Ebola is present in the human population because of the close contact through secretions, body fluids, blood, and organs of the wild animals such as chimpanzees, fruit bats, forest antelope, monkeys, gorillas, and porcupines. In human beings, virus transmission occurs through body fluids, blood, and contaminated objects with body fluids such as vomit, feces, blood, or the death of an individual. The incubation period for this virus ranges from the infection until the appearance of symptoms. It leads to symptoms like sore throat, headache, muscle pain, fever, and fatigue, which is later on followed by vomiting, rashes, diarrhea, impaired liver and kidney functions, external and internal bleeding, along with others. The diagnosis of Ebola virus is quite tricky because the symptoms of the disease are similar to various infectious conditions like typhoid, fever, malaria, or meningitis. The confirmation of the disease is done through multiple tests such as the ELISA. For example, the antigen capture enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay, antigen capture detection tests, reverse transcriptase polymerase chain reaction or RT-PCR assay, serum neutralization tests, and virus isolation through cell culture and electron microscopy. Doctors recommend various other criteria for the proper diagnosis of the disease. Outbreak control relies on proper interventions, prevention of infection, infection control, management of the patients, contact tracing and surveillance, appropriate laboratory services in town, along with social mobilization. How can you improve your survival rate is the next big question, if you have the Ebola virus. During the initial days, you need to keep yourself hydrated, approach for symptomatic treatment, so that it helps in improving the survival rate. It is usually advised by healthcare professionals to opt for IV fluids and oral fluids for improvement in survival rate. In today's world, there is no appropriate treatment protocol for neutralizing the damage of the Ebola virus. Still, various therapies are under development, like immunological, blood, or drug therapies, which might help in relieving the symptoms of the disease. Early supportive care is advised for breastfeeding and pregnant patients as well.